I will do my unarmed strike.
And knock out Morden.
Okay, then I'm going to use my bonus attack. I don't have any flurry of blows left.
Oh, thank gosh.
But I've got a bonus attack where I'm going to attack the orange guy.
How dare you?
Roll the hit.
That is a 17.
That hits.
For 7 damage.
Blech.
Oh, wow.
That's my monk skills.
I'm just going to move up there so it's a bit more organized. Alright, and then...
Yeah, it's the end of my turn, for sure.
Okay. Peter, what you doing? There's 2 dead spiders next to you.
Yeah. I don't think I can get over to that other spider in one
crossbow
move.
Crossbow won't go that far?
No, I mean to actually get over there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, that's like 40 feet away.
Yeah. I'm gonna squeeze my way through here to get a clear shot so it's not hiding behind the giant carcass.
Alright.
And my bonus action will be to sheathe one of my scimitars, and then I can use my Ray of Frost, which misses.
What'd you get?
That's 5, 3 plus 2.
Five. Okay.
And that was everything. Yeah.
All right, Harman, what you doing?
I'm gonna focus my attacks now on yellow since he's the only living spider. First, start off with a rapier finesse attack using 1d20. Let me use the right d20 this time. That's a 2 plus 3 is 5.
That misses.
Okay. Am I able to use my axe attack?
I will say yes because you just used a weapon attack.
Okay, so I'll go ahead and roll a regular d20 for that. That's a 19.
That hits. Roll your damage.
And a stone axe is 2d4 plus 1, so let's grab blue, and let's grab metal one. 3 and 1 is 4, plus 1 is 5, right? Yep.
Wait, so what's the total damage you just did?
5.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to do?
Yeah, I guess so. Would that be considered flanking him since we're Peter's opposite of him?
No, flanking would be when there's like directly on either side.
Oh, okay. Well then.
But
no.
Move there anyway because that'll make it easier for next.
Okay, yeah. I'll move
here. All right, is that your turn?
Yep.
Martin, want to make a strength check?
Kind of do.
All right, make your strength roll.
12.
That is exactly enough what you needed.
Yay! I'm a weak little guy. I barely could do it.
And that was your action. Do you want to have a bonus action you'd like to use, or?
I don't believe I have anything I can do, so... You know what? I'm going to move right here, so in case it happens, Harmon can have... advantage.
Yo! Alright. The spider's gonna make an attack at you, Morden.
I'm okay. I'm closing my eyes.
I'm assuming a 16 hits.
Ah!
Sorry, that wasn't a 16. I apologize. That's an 18.
Oh, well, yeah, that would.
I'm very sorry for making that mistake. And I think it's... Yay! If I remember correctly. Yeah. That is 9 damage.
Yep.
Alright, and that's gonna be his turn. Wolda, what you doing?
Alright, do I have space to move here?
I would say you can make it, yeah.
Okay, so I will move there, and then I will do my unarmed strike.
And knock out Morden.
No!
No, please, you guys, please. Seriously? Why do you jinx me like that?
Was it a nat one?
That was a nat one.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Oh my god!
Wait.
Because I have a plus +7 to hit, but it was
hold
a
on,
nat
hold
one.
Hold on. Is it a nat one if you're rolling with advantage and one of them is a one?
That's actually a
should
good
should have advantage,
point.
Right?
Yeah, oh, no, phew. You have advantage.
Oh, phew. Please don't roll another one.
Please.
It's a dirty 25.
Okay.
No!
8 damage.
How dare you? How absolute dare you would you do that? That was not necessary in the slightest.
Thank you, Peter. Do you want me to describe how I kill this one now?
No.
You seem very interested in this session, so I just want to make sure about that.
I will get the timeout square back, I swear.
question.
Are we still in combat?
Yeah.
No, you're not in combat.
Okay.
Well, then I'm going to move over to this chest and start opening it.
All right. Mine.
Can I investigate the room?
Make an investigation check.
All right. I want to see if there's anything. Investigation or perception?
Whichever one you want to do.
Then that would be perception.
Peter's running the chest.
That's an 11. That'll be
acro. Actually, I'm going to roll acrobatics.
if you're letting me do the choice.
No, I'm not.
Then that was an 11, so.
You're able to see a bit more of like the roof in the room. There's still spiderwebs everywhere, but you can see there was kind of like a small area in which there were some rocks and stuff that had shown some daylight.
Okay. I assume these guys are going through the chest. This big pile of webs in the middle?
Yeah.
Is that where the spider came from? Did I miss that, or?
It looks like a nest.
It looks like a nest. Okay.
Don't
is there?
Touch
can
it.
I investigate the nest specifically?
You are welcome to do that. That would specifically be investigation. There's no choice in that one.
Okay. And then that's only a 5.
All right. Pretty web. They sparkle and look shiny.
I've got a feeling that there's got to be something here about our main quest, and that's where I'm.
Well, yes, there is something here about our main quest.
Is there? You kind of cut out at the last second there.
Yeah. There's got to be. Because I need everybody to get over here so I can read this book.
Oh, I don't want to read.
All right. I'll come over and I'll open up that chest.
All right. We'll go from bottom to top just because I don't want to read the book yet. I'm not gonna lie to you and say like, oh no, because I want you guys to get the treasure. I just don't want to read the book yet. I have the document open and everything for you guys. I just feel like making you suffer.
If Peter reads a book, can I read a book? I've got books here.
No.
Wow. You are the only one not allowed to read. And that's for no reason other than I'm choosing to spite you.
Yeah, I kind of feel like that this time.
So, Harmon, you get that's a 46, an iron helmet.
Ooh. Yay! I'm gonna go ahead and equip that.
All right.
You're already
I will...
wearing one.
Am I?
Yes, you are.
You don't remember these things, it's okay.
Equipment. Oh, iron helmet. I am. Look at that. Okay, then I.
Oh, you're gonna wear two. You just put one on top of the other. Double protection.
You're taller now.
All right, Morden, you get a medallion of thoughts.
Ooh, I'd have no clue what I'm gonna do with that.
A medallion of thoughts was a magic item that allowed its users to read minds. The medallion allowed anyone wearing it to cast a detect thought spell up to 3 times a day. It recovered part of its magical capabilities at every dawn.
Huh. I don't think I want to read Woldo's mind.
I'll give you a hint what my thoughts are. It's not about punching you in the face.
That's debatable.
All right. Woldo, you got a... Actually, you also got a snake staff.
Oh, wow.
Is it the same
can
one?
Can you use the staff as a weapon itself, or is it only yes. as the same thing?
Yes, it is. It also, I think it works as a quarterstaff as well.
It is a staff, yeah.
It just so happens to be magical. And Peter, are you looking in that chest?
Yeah, I'm looking in this one.
All right.
How much coin would this helmet be worth?
That depends on what trades you get when you find a village.
Okay, sure.
Peter, you get slippers of spider climbing.
Oh, that would have been nice.
So you're probably like little shoes that look like spiders, so you might not be interested in
Well, they're slippers, right?
They look like ballerina slippers.
Yeah.
Then they are definitely not armor. Okay.
I was gonna say you don't want to wear them around Morden.
They don't look like spiders at all. It's like a bright pink. They have like the ribbons on them. Morden, you get your two arrows back.
Thank you.
I got a feeling that you're doing. And that's it for the chest you guys have checked out so far.
Did we? Okay, I was going to say, there's a middle chest.
Harvey's like, I got the last one!
Yeah, I want to run up to here. And
what do we, the staff, what is the staff, do we call it?
Staff.
It's called the Staff of the Python. I'll send you a link to the stats you're using, because we're not doing a Python, because that's really overpowered.
Okay. The staff, the Staff of the Garter Snake, then?
Staff of the Corn Snake.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's a snake, yeah, that you can use up to 3 times.
Gentlemen, is there anybody here who thinks they might make use of such a staff? Really within my wheelhouse, so to say.
I've got high animal handling, if that helps.
It doesn't really matter. It still kind of listens to the person who holds the staff.
I like snakes.
Or held.
Okay, I might actually want to check out what the stats are as a weapon. Just I'm curious, but I may be willing to relinquish this to someone who might make better use of it.
Possession?
I'm going to put these slippers on.
Everybody needs a little bit of help walking.
Peter has his bright pink ballerina slippers on now, so he can walk up walls.
Nice.
They've got a nice web pattern on.
It's a very faint one, like it's like done in like a silk thread that's like white on the pink. It looks really pretty. There's like some beads and pearls sewn into it. All right, and I feel like
Harmon's dancing.
You're dancing. You want the chest? You in the chest? You find an iron sword. Ooh. And you find a magical scroll.
Dun, dun,
dun. On this is a scroll, as you can kind of tell from what's written on it, of almost like a key. This is a lock, like kind of, I can't remember the word. It cancels a lock spell.
It opens the door to beginning.
Yep.
And that's all you guys find there.
Good, okay. Everybody, before we do anything else.
I don't want to.
Can I ask a question about the Staff of Python before we do anything else? I did find it in the list. Is the damage on it the same?
No. Yeah, the damage would be the same damage.
Because I've got 1D6. Two. I got a 1d6 and a 1d8 bludgeoning.
Yes, that depends on whether you're holding it one-handed or two-handed.
Which one is which?
The higher would be two-handed.
Pardon? Yeah.
The weaker is
you're holding it. Yes. If you're holding it in one hand, it's a 1d6. And if you switch to a two-handed grasp, it's 1d8.
Okay.
Hit harder.
You're using both your arms to slam it down.
Stick-o-bonk.
Now, how does it affect my unarmed strike, then? If I'm using it one-handed, can I still use an unarmed strike?
I would say yes.
Okay, so that means I could still use a flurry of blows. Do I have to call out if I'm using it one-handed or two-handed?
I'm gonna say I'll assume it's one-handed.
Okay.
Because really, at the end of the day, even it doesn't matter because, in my opinion, because you can easily hit with it, remove your hand, and punch.
That's true. I guess it's just it's not like I'm picking up another weapon with it.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
That's the only reason why.
Keep it because it does look like it's pretty good. My one concern was my flurry of blows. So.
Yeah.
It would affect that, but okay. No, I'm good with that.
We'll do. Right.
I know possessions, but
no,
this is
actually,
a pretty good possession.
If you don't want one with a snake, I have a regular bow staff that you could use.
Is it the damage the same?
Yes. It would, yeah. Yeah, because the damage part isn't magical.
I you know what? I would be willing to take a regular bow staff. The magic itself is you know, unnecessary for me, but I would be willing to trade you, good sir, Harmon there.
Or Morden.
Yes, I'm sorry. You half-men sometimes look very similar to each other. It's it is quite perturbing sometimes.
It is.
I'll tell you, the snake isn't as great as you would think at first.
It's a snake. There's nothing great about a snake.
It's an extra character, by the way, character.
I will send you the link to the snake and just kind of like the like mini kind of what I've altered it to, just so it's a bit more even.
Mm-hmm.
I will trade you.
That sounds good. I probably will trade it with Morden then, though.